Hey kids, welcome back. I hope you guys are having a good day. I wanted to share one story with you that's one of my favorite stories in the Bible, and it's all about Jesus. And I know we can sometimes read over these stories, and sometimes they just become so repetitive, and you're like, yeah, I know that story. But I really wanted to help you and encourage you with today's story. And it's found in the book of John, and it's found in chapter 6. And the one passage I want to talk to you about is when Jesus feeds the 5,000. And I'm going to start with verse 11, and then I'll end at verse 12, okay? So here's what it says. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes as much as they would. Now check this out in verse number 12. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, gather up the fragments that remain, that nothing be lost. So here's, you guys all see this. So this is a loaf of bread, right? And I hope I can help you guys understand that every time you pick up maybe a loaf of bread to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or make a sandwich or whatever it is or put in the toaster, I hope this reminds you about the story of Jesus. Now, in the story of Jesus, Jesus did some really, really cool things. But what's amazing about this story is all the people that were involved. There was the disciples, and there was the little boy, the young boy, who had the five loaves and two fishes. Now, maybe there's a story in this lesson we can learn. Oh, you know, the Bible talks about of the little boy that gave his lunch. I mean, that's good and all, but what is that story really trying to tell us? Well, I'm pretty sure it's wanting us to focus in back on who Jesus is. Now, the little boy was available, and he did have his lunch ready, and he was willing to give it to Jesus, and he did. The disciples were kind of like, you know, worried, well, what do we do? How are we going to feed all these people? And what Jesus really likes to do is he likes to take really bad situations and just turn them into good for his glory. And you know, this whole pandemic that we're in, it's a bad situation. I'm not going to lie to you guys. It's tough. It's a difficult situation, but who do we look to? Do we trust our own selves, that we keep our own selves safe or making sure that everybody else is doing what they should be doing? Or do we really focus in on who Jesus is and what he can do? Now, in this story, everybody had a need. They were all hungry. If you're like me, Pastor Sherwin likes to eat. Eating is wonderful. Eating is great. And it's something that we need every day. We have to eat. Otherwise, we're just going to starve to death. But there's one need that surpasses even that. And it's a need that every person on this planet has. They need a savior. They need a person who can save them from their sin. And what I'll tell you right now, it's only Jesus who can save people from their sin. Now, these are really cool stories that Jesus fed the 5,000. Great miracle, and multiple miracles throughout the Bible, the New Testament, of what Jesus did. But I truly believe the greatest miracle is when Jesus died to pay for our sin and so that we can trust him and believe in him and be saved. What are we saved from? The punishment of sin. The power of sin, all those things, and it's all because of Jesus. Now, maybe you're sitting here today and you're like, you know what? I've never trusted in Jesus. Here's what I would encourage you to do. I hope you would take the time to talk to maybe your parents, or you can have your parents email me or text or call, and I would love to share with you what it means to have a relationship with Jesus. And what does it mean when Jesus saves me? And I would love to tell you guys about that. And maybe you have a chance to talk with your parents about what does it mean to be a Christian? And I'll tell you this, those that believe and trust in Jesus, the Bible clearly says their sins would be forgiven and they would have a home in heaven when they die. And I hope you guys would remember that, because honestly, I can make up all these cool videos, but in the end, the only thing I would want you to know more than anything is that Jesus loves you, Jesus died for you, Jesus rose from the grave so that you could have a relationship with God. And I hope you can make that decision to trust in Jesus and believe in Jesus that he would be your savior. Well, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Remember, anytime you guys take up a piece of bread, remember, there's all these other things about the story, but who was the main person in the story? It was Jesus. So next time you make a sandwich, think about Jesus and what he's done. You guys have a great day. We'll talk to you guys online later.